What up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. It's Julia Tamika, and today I'm going to bring you guys into this deployed life, okay? I feel like my camera's crooked. And I'm gonna show you guys my dorm room. So if you don't know, I am in the military, I'm in the Air Force. Been here 14 years now, you know, holding it down, America. But this is my first deployment. I'm deployed to Qatar. I don't know if you can see my shirt, but it says Qatar. And yeah, this is the first time that I've actually been on a deployment. I haven't lived in a dorm room in this space, this type of space, since tech school, and that was like 2010. So yeah, it's been an experience. But I wanna show you guys like how I decorate it, how I've been living, what this little dorm life is about, at least here at Al Udeid. All deployments are not created equal. Every person, even on this base, like lives differently. So I'll show you guys mine. And if you like this video, like it actually on YouTube. But let me know what you guys think in the comments. Make sure you subscribe, share, you know, and if you want more tips, tricks, advice, about the military, let me know. All right, so let's get into it. Therefore, go and make disciples of all of the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Matthew chapter 28, verse 19. All right, so this is how outside of the buildings look. This is our living quarter area. I lived in A8. And yeah, we walking back from the DFAC, the dining facility, this is my view. We had a little patio area outside where people would grill and whatnot sometimes. Actually, they left the water bottles on the outside in the patio area one time when they were grilling, and they caught on fire, but that's neither here nor there. But yeah, this is how the inside of the building looks. There's three different bays that you walk through. I was in C bay, so me coming from the DFAC side, I had to walk through all three bays to get to my room. It's where we have our bicycles, storage, and then there's public restrooms on the bottom floor as well, which comes very much in handy when your suite mate is in the bathroom and you really have to go. I would literally just come downstairs and use the bathroom in the hallway. You gotta do what you gotta do, man. You gotta do what you gotta do. Apparently people be stealing bikes, so it's signs posted everywhere to not steal the bikes. But yeah, this is how I was living for a year, and this was my daily route to and from my room. Doesn't it look like jail? I feel like this is exactly what jail looks like. Like, it's giving prison. It's definitely giving prison. They didn't even like do the floors correctly. Like, I ain't never seen nothing like it. Like, y'all could at least make sure like the floors, like the top coat was on there, so like over time it wouldn't look like how it looks. And if you think those floors are bad, wait till you see the floors in our rooms. But yes, I lived on the second floor, so it was only two floors, which wasn't too bad. I didn't have to walk up like many flights of stairs. There's no elevators, of course. I live right next to the laundry room, which it could be a good and a bad thing. There's definitely pros and cons because I could hear them. But I also didn't have to walk far. So literally my room is right there, C202.
So in my room, go watch that video if you haven't already. And this is literally my space. I just did a 360. That's the room. Some people actually share this space and have a roommate and a, some people sleep on a top and some people sleep on a bottom. I don't share a room, so it's just me. I'll show you though.
Walk in. Got that there. Little desk. Got some little art for you, abstract. My desk.
And this is where I put my shoes. I bought the majority of these shoes since I've been here. So that's the Madden Things Converse. This is the mirror. Some pictures from my unit they sent me for Christmas. This was a chaotic holiday party. A girl sent me that. She's my riding buddy. To go with my family, what's it? London. More pictures from my unit. Here's the room from this angle.
That's my storage.
This is my bed. Over here is my perfume collection. I have to bring my things with me. I think I only got this since I've been here.
Yeah, you see it.
Jewelry box with all my goodies. Lots of money in there. My shades, glasses, TV. Got some books back here that I just got from the library that I've been reading. This was a gift. Plastic that I found. My vitamins.
Kind of got to get in where you fit in. All these drawers
have clothes in them. I actually use the drawers. Down here is more storage space. I put my uniforms in there. And then other clothes. That's the bed. Nightstand. So all this furniture comes with a room. The lamp, nightstand, bed, of course, that desk. This, it doesn't come with the TV. There's my trash can over there. The floors are pretty disgusting. So I'm glad I got rugs and things. I have more rugs back there, but we'll get to that point. And this is like my little storage area. I have my medicine. I got this when I was in Ireland. My medicine, my uniform items, like scarf and patch and things. Some costume jewelry. I like face stuff, makeup, hair, body, other things, miscellaneous. Use this. Yeah. My mirror, I put this on the wall myself. Oh shoot. There you go. So let's go. What else do we have here? This is like your bathroom / sink area. Here's mine. It's nice and clean. This does have a cabinet behind it, a bunch of things. What else? These hooks came on the doors already. So someone who previously lived there, here, you put them up there. I just use this for my towel. This is for my jewelry bag. Use this to hang up my purses. This is where I put my uniform at the end of the day. Hang it up there. Here's my robe. Sweatshirt, because I got kind of gold. Another hoodie right there. Here's my gym bag. What else? My closet. So we do get like a little deep closet. Mine is pretty packed, as you can see. So we got laundry, dirty clothes. This is a gorilla box that I got shipped here. I don't need these boxes. Actually, I don't need them right now, but I might need them in the future, so I kept them. Laundry basket, boots that I bought. Another pair of box of shoes down under there. Some Jordans that I bought. Got my bags hung up. I think I put these in here myself. I did. And then I basically purchased a whole new wardrobe since I've been out here. I did not come with this much clothes at all. So I'm going to have a lot of stuff to ship back. Came with that. Didn't come with that. Came with that. My suitcase is under here. It's a little, you know, congested, but it's a closet storage. What is that? Iron board. And then, you know, all black people got plastic bags somewhere. All right. So we also have a little kitchenette. This is mine. I don't have a roommate. This room is empty. So this whole space is mine.
They gave us a table, 4 chairs. Someone left the ice machine, so I have an ice machine. Transformer for that. I need to wash my dishes, but that's just from like earlier. Little get fine section, you know, proteins, teas, and things. My Goli gummies. Make my arm really long. Goli gummies. We have cabinets. Some people actually be in their room like cooking. I don't be doing all of that. The previous girl who lived here, she loved to cook and she left all of this food. I don't be eating none of this. This was hers too. And then spices and stuff, but food for me is free. There is like a little cooking thing right there. And down here, I do have some pots and pans, but I feel like it's more of a hassle to cook than not to cook. This is my little snack cabinet down here. A lot of people sent me some goodies, some care packages, whatever. They did give us a microwave. I purchased this for my tea. And then for my hookah, for my Goli box, that was there. That's an old one. My shisha. That was also gifted to me. Yeah. It's a nice one. Okay, don't look at that. That's the top. This is what goes on top of the shisha. It's like a clear acrylic. You know what? This isn't about the shisha, but you can see it. Clear acrylic. What else? So, bathroom is this way. Some cleaning supplies. And mop. I'll be here mopping, but there's only so much you can do. The floor is going to look like that regardless. Bathroom. You see how white my roof is? Some people have like mold and stuff in their room. It's pretty nasty. I try to keep my room really clean, so this is how it is. Oops. Yeah, not bad. And if it is bad, I've gotten used to it. So I clean as much as I can clean. It's trash. Took my braids out the other day. This little weave and stuff. And yeah. So yeah, that's how I've been living out here, guys. I went from my big old house, 4 bedrooms, 3.5 bathrooms, big old yard, my car, everything, to this. And I'm almost done. It's been an experience. Would I volunteer for it again? Too soon to ask me that question. But you know, it has been an experience. I do love Doha, and I'll be showing you guys lots of Doha. I love Doha. I would move back here to Qatar. I moved to Qatar. Would I stay on Udeid Air Base? Probably not. But yeah, this is how I've been living, y'all. This is my home for now. And yeah. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Make sure you like this video, comment, subscribe to my channel. First of all, turn on your, you know, little notification, so when I do post a video, you'll see it first. Let me know what else you guys would like to see from me. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Yeah.